Innovation, Facilities, and also Quality Assurance. She also shows Appaloosa horses. She owns two of those, and she's been showing horses since she was 12 years old, so she has lots of experience with that. She also plays clarinet in her local band. She's been playing clarinet for lots of years as well. And today she's going to share with us her knowledge about hot mix asphalt and also the methods that they use to develop updates to the specification books for construction. So please welcome Julie Townsend.
I'm tired of this. I just want to go home and ride. Where did these barrels come from? And Greg, you're probably stuck too. You want your half price shakes for the happy hour. Oh, gosh. Oh, construction. Oh. But when you think about it, there's a whole lot of planning that goes on before you ever get to the construction zone. And that's where I come in, and that's my role, one of my roles at MDOT. Because what we do, we don't just chuck projects out there casually. We have a lot of advanced planning. And usually a project will take a year, maybe even 2 years or more before you actually see the barrel and the people with the vests and the hats and all that good stuff out there. And even beyond that project, there is the planning to keep everything consistent statewide, keep costs down, use the taxpayer money efficiently. And that's where I come in my role. Because what MDOT does is we have our book of standard specifications for construction. And pretty much we use this job for, or this book for any job you see out there on the road. At some point they're using something out of this book. Every contract has to be in this. And my role at MDOT is to approve variations to this book. Because, you know, between Metro Detroit and the Upper Peninsula, flat areas, rolling terrain, there can be a lot of variations. Sometimes you do need to vary from this. And what we also need to do is keep this book up to date. This one was put out in 12. Things change. There's new ideas, new construction methods, new crash barriers, new mixed designs for different concretes, what have you. So there's not really a set schedule on this, but when there starts to be a lot of changes, and I'm having to approve a lot of special provisions to change this book, then we go ahead and revise the book and put out a new one so that we have fewer of these variations coming through me all the time, or the other guy I work with. So what management has done is they've decided that we're putting out a new book in 2020. And just like I talked about the plannings for all these projects, we don't just tuck them out there. We're right now planning for the 2020 book that will be in effect for the 2020 construction season. And now I'm going to narrow it down to what my role is on these committees. I'm on the Division 8 committee, and basically that is incidental construction. All the little stuff that you kind of never thought about, the guardrails, the traffic signals, the field offices, little trailer signal there, the HMA curb, the hot mix asphalt curb. So within Division 8, I'm in charge for the champion for section 805. Kind of a obscure little section. This is the whole thing here, page and like a third. I'm in charge of researching what's going on with this, if we need to do changes, because we look at the whole book. Nothing gets left unturned. And with hot mix asphalt curb, let me explain a little bit about what it is. You're probably more used to seeing concrete curb, more of the white or the gray off to the side. That's more of what you're going to see around here in Lansing. I don't think you'll see any of this in Lansing. curb is meant to primarily control the runoff of the water of the road and channel it down to a catch basin, drainage ditch, whatever it has to be. But it's not necessarily, concrete's not necessarily the best choice all over the state. There are times where, especially in remote areas, your whole project's the hot mix asphalt, the black top or the darker material there. It would be very expensive to bring in concrete to do a couple little runs here and there. So in those cases, we go ahead and use the asphalt instead. And when I say less used, we had about 200 uses of hot mix asphalt curb in the last 5 years. And in comparison for the concrete, you might have 40 or 50 uses in a month. So it's by far lesser use. And because we leave no stone unturned, what we look at is we go through it and make sure we're still happy with how we're using it, even though it's not used a lot. It's used enough to keep it, not a lot to get rid of it, but we still want it, so we look it over. And basically, there aren't a lot of questions and changes on this. So I've formed a committee, and we've reviewed this. There's a few chances in here where it's not really worded the best. Like at one point we said, let the HMA cure for a certain amount of time. Well, in the world of asphalt, you don't cure asphalt, you cure concrete. So we changed some wording on it. So basically what I'm presenting to you all today is the fact that we've went through this, we've wordsmithed a few areas, but there's really no technology changes. It's not cause any issues. No one's asking to change stuff very often. So basically we're doing a few wordsmiths, and I welcome you to review the file for hot mix asphalt curb and just see if there's anything else you've come across. But right now the committee is recommending just some wordsmithing changes, and we're keeping it pretty much as is. So in conclusion, provide any comments you might have on it. And we have till the approximate end of the calendar year. We put it through upper management, and then we put it out to industry, all the contractors and the providers of hot mix asphalt, to get their comments. So we can receive comments through pretty much the end of the calendar year. And I invite your comments, and thank you for your time.